Hey guys, so for number two, we're going to solve the absolute value inequality. Now, other than no solution, we're going to use interval notation to express the solution set and graph the solution set on the number line. So the first thing that we should notice here is that the absolute value is by itself, which is great because since it is by itself, we can go ahead and take it off. So what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite our 3x plus 1 plus 9 less than or equal to 12, but we're also going to rewrite it as greater than or equal to negative 12. So what I did was I made the right hand side negative and then I changed the sign. So that's going to give us all the possibilities for x inside of this absolute value. So now we're going to solve each side respectively. So here, let's subtract 9, giving us 3 times x plus 1 less than or equal to 3. Divide by 3 gives us x plus 1 is less than or equal to 3 over 3, which is the same thing as 1. So I don't need those parentheses anymore, so I'm going to take them off. And then let's subtract 1. Giving us x is less than or equal to 0. Here on the right-hand side, we're going to go through the same thing, but you're going to quickly see we're going to get different numbers. This is going to give us 3 times x plus 1 is greater than or equal to negative 21. And then we're going to divide by 3 again. That's going to give us x plus 1 is greater than or equal to negative 21 over 3, which is the same thing as negative 7. So let's subtract 1. Giving us x is greater than or equal to negative 8. So from here, we can draw this on the graph and then draw this on the graph and see where they overlap. Or we can write this together as negative 8 is less than or equal to x, which is less than or equal to 0. I just went ahead and put those two together. So let's go ahead and draw that on the number line. Let's make the left-hand side blue and the right-hand side green. So x is less than or equal to 0, it means that 0 is my critical point. And because it is less than or equal to, it is going to be a closed circle. And x is smaller, so that means it's going to go towards the left. So I'm just going to write a little arrow here going towards left. Now for x is greater than or equal to negative 8, my critical point is negative 8. Because it is greater than or equal to, it's going to be a closed circle as well. And because x is greater than negative 8, it's going to go towards the right-hand side. So I'm just going to draw another arrow going this way. So as you can see, it looks like our lines overlap between negative 8 and 0. And the question is telling us to put it in interval. And the question is telling us to put the answer in interval notation. So we're going to do just that. We're going to make sure it's in interval notation, which basically means that we're going to use either brackets or parentheses to write our answer. So this is a closed circle, so we have a bracket. We start at negative 8. We continue on until 0. And 0 is also another closed bracket because it is less than or equal to. So our interval notation is going to be from negative 8, including negative 8, to 0, including 0. And the graph is going to look like this.